Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson of geography, that is our changing earth. Today we are going to study about the major landforms of the earth. In the last lectures we have studied about the endogenic forces and the exogenic forces. Now we have studied how the endogenic forces, that is the forces from the interior of the earth, bring the changes on the earth's surface. Now the changes that we see on the earth's surface have the different agents which work on them. So in short, today we are going to study about the changes that take place on the earth surface, how they work on the earth surface, and different landforms are formed. So let us start today about the major landforms of the earth. Now the landscape is being continuously worn by the two processes. Now children, the landforms which are formed on the earth surface, they have different agents working with them. The continuous worn out of the landscape is done by the two processes known as weathering and erosion. Now, what is weathering? Weathering is nothing but the breaking up of the rocks on the earth surface. Now, how these rocks breaks on the earth surface? By the action of temperature, wind, rainfall. Wind has a very high pressure, and by these winds also the rocks break down into the small sediments. Thus, by the action of temperature, wind and water, these rocks start breaking down and they fall on the earth's surface into the small sediments. And the second process is erosion. What is erosion? Erosion is the wearing away of the landscape by the different natural agents. Now what are these? The erosion, you know, erosion, when these rocks breaks down into small sediments, they are eroded by the action of water, wind, ice, etc. And these are the natural agents which erode the material. So these are the two processes which continuously take place on the earth's surface, because of which the landscape is worn out. So weathering is the process which breaks the rocks by the action of wind, temperature and rainfall. And erosion is the process which erodes the material by the action of water, wind and ice. Now keeping in mind these two processes, let us see the changes that have taken place on the earth's surface by the action of wind, water, air and ice. Now the changes which took place on the earth surface by the endogenic and the exogenic forces are changed by the action of wind, water, air and ice. So first of all, let us see how does the river changes the landscape, how does the river bring the changes on the landforms formed on the earth surface. So work of the river, what is the work of the river? Now different landforms are formed by the river, such as waterfall, Oxbow Lake, flood plains and delta. Now how does the river forms these landforms? Let us see. Now river has a course to flow. Rivers flow in the three courses, that is the upper course, the middle course and the lower course. When the river originates from the glacier, that is when it starts from the mountain, it has a great force and it falls from the mountain and it comes through the valleys, and when it enters the plain, it changes shape. First of all, let us see the waterfall. Now how the waterfalls are formed by the river? When the water, when the soft rock, the running water. See here, children, I will explain you. Now suppose this is the earth crust and these are the rocks. Now these are the layers. This is the hard rock and this is the hard rocks and this is the soft rocks. So when the water flows, this is the soft. When the water flows from the hard rock, starts eroding the soft rocks and thus it forms the waterfalls. Soft rock, slowly, slowly it gets eroded on the earth's surface and the waterfalls are formed. Now children, I will give you one example. Suppose if you will take one glass of water and if you will pour it on your head, it will fall with a great force directly. But if you will throw the glass of water on a floor, it will go slowly by taking the different shape. Same way, when the river, when it originates from the mountains, when it falls from the mountains, it falls with a great force. And when the river enters the plain, its speed decreases and the rivers, because of the unequal level of the plain surface, it flows with the different shape. And these curved shape, when it takes the shape, it curves down. These are called meanders. The fast flowing water erodes the river bank here, and the slow flowing and the slow moving material deposits here the material. And so what happened? These eroded, the river changed its shape, and these two shapes come closer to each other. The slow, see here, the fast flowing river erodes the river bank here and it deposits the sediment here. And so this part of the river, it gets cut, the river changes its position and it starts moving from here, and this part of the river is called the oxbow lake because it takes the shape of the bow like an ox. And so this part is separated and the river starts flowing. The river changes its direction of flowing by because it starts depositing the eroded material. This is about the waterfall and how the rivers form, how the river changes into the meander and forms the oxbow lakes. Now let us see how the flood plains are formed. Now children, suppose that this is the river bank and the river is flowing this way. Some river at times overflow its areas, its overflow. For example, during the rainy season, the flood takes place, and because of the increase in the water level, it comes up to this position. It forms the, because of the flood, the water overflows. So this is the area which is called the flood bank. But after some time, when the level of the water decreases, the water goes to its original position. But the water which was overflow has deposited the soil and the mud on this place, which forms the flood plains. Flood deposits the soil and the other materials which remains there only, and thus this forms the flood plain. This area is called the flood plain. I hope you have understood how the flood plains are formed. Now let us see the last one. When the river approaches towards the sea, the speed of the river decreases and the river begins to break up into the number of streams. And these streams are called distributaries. These distributaries also carry the load, that is the sediment, and they deposit at the mouth of the sea thus forming the delta. Delta is a landform at the mouth of the river by the deposition of the sediments that is carried by the distributaries of the rivers. So, and here the river, this way the river flows in the three courses forming the different landforms. So for today only we have studied about the work of the river.